So this is the Snyder Cut explained for dummies. The Snyder Cut is the original cut of the Justice League, directed by Zack Snyder. It was originally longer than 3.5 hours, but the movie underwent a rewrite before principal photography due to the backlash to Batman vs. Superman, as Zack screened a 2.5 hour cut of that 3.5 hour original cut for the studio. Well, the studio wasn't satisfied, and they assembled a writer's room to implement changes to the Snyder Cut, the 2-hour version. Unfortunately, before he could complete another version, Snyder had to step away from his directing duties due to a family tragedy, although it was speculated that he was already fired from Justice League, because Warner Brothers wanted to move away from Snyder's darker style after the reception of Batman vs. Superman. To finish production, Warner Brothers hired Joss Whedon, who added about 80 new pages to the script. Now, the movie, which was released in the theaters, was a mix of the footage from the original 3.5 hour cut and the additional shoots by Joss Whedon. Justice League was such a disappointment theatrically, and fans mounted a campaign for Snyder's original cut. Then, early this year, it was announced that a 4-hour version of Justice League is coming to HBO Max. Now, this is the version that was originally shot by Zack Snyder, most of which was removed from the 2017's theatrical release. And this included an extended 20 minutes of Darkseid War with Diana's narration, Superman with a black suit, more backstory to each of the characters, especially for Cyborg. Iris West was also a part of Flash's introduction in the film. Steppenwolf, who is actually scary and really spiky. Possibly the inclusion of Martian Manhunter, and maybe teasing Green Lantern, among other characters like the Atom. A dark tone to the film, as expected with DC and Snyder's past work. A totally different ending compared to 2017's version. Inclusion of Jared Leto's Joker, but this time with a more serious and dark portrayal of the infamous character, unlike his portrayal in 2016's Suicide Squad. DCEU's Robin's backstory and how Ben Affleck dealt with his death after Joker killed him. Batman, who was dropping F-bombs. Darkseid cameos at the start and the end of the movie. An extended version of the post-credits scene featuring Deathstroke, with the possibility of other Injustice League characters joining the cause of Lex Luthor to set up Justice League 2. Also, this version does not feature the infamous CGI mustache of Superman. And also not a single second from the footage shot by Joss Whedon. So that's good, right? Among many other new scenes and storylines. So, the Snyder Cut we are going to get in March 2021 is the finished version of that original 3.5 hour cut, plus some additional footage shot by Zack Snyder last month, which makes our cut around 4 hours long. So please, dummies, stop saying it's the same movie, because it's really not. Till we meet again in another video, this is Chow for now. Don't forget to subscribe and hit that like button.
Now,
Zack Snyder's Justice League
is going to be released on HBO Max, which is available in very few countries at the moment. And if you don't live there, then how are you going to watch it? Well, that's why we partnered up with NordVPN today, because it allows you to bypass internet censorship, which means even if you don't live in the country where HBO Max is available, all you need to do is select the location of the country where it is available, connect it, and boom, you can now watch HBO Max. Same can be done with other streaming services like Disney Plus, Netflix, Prime Video, whatever. So you can access shows from different countries with a click of a button. Plus, it does so many things like encrypting your internet, protects your online identity, and so much. That's why we're offering you guys a special deal only for our viewers. Now, if you sign up using our code SCRNCULT, then you can get 68% off on a 2-year plan, plus one additional month for free. So that's just over $3 a month, which is really cheap when it comes to your security, your privacy, and more importantly, your entertainment. So sign up to NordVPN using our code SCRNCULT, that's C-U-L-T, to get 68% off on a 2-year plan and one additional month for free. And I almost forgot, the link to sign up is in the description down below.
Don't forget to like and subscribe.